Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of DesignTech. And in today's episode, we are going to be doing something very, very awesome. You see this mess? This is my Emmy system, and it is a disaster. It is a mess. It's horrible, and it needs to be dealt with quickly. And so, that is exactly what I'm going to do. So, we are going to need a few things. First and foremost, we're going to need some Emmy drives. I've spent some time between episodes setting some of this stuff up, doing a lot of the grindy stuff, the making of all the circuits and all this kind of stuff, so hopefully we'll be okay. I think we'll be okay. Now, this Emmy system is completely and totally full right now, so yeah, that's going to be an issue. We do have more Emmy drives than we actually need. Let's see. If we look at storage components, I have 160 of the 16K. That took so long to make, by the way. I'm almost tempted. Let's do this. Let's make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of those guys. And then we are going to make 10 of these 4K ME storage cells, and that way I can hook up one more of these right here. And we'll just throw those in there, and that will open up some more space for us in our ME network so stuff can continue to flow in there, which is what we want, because we're pretty much out of space. I don't actually need all of these ME drives. I just need, for now, 16 of them. Because, as I said, I have 160 of the big storage cells, so this'll do for now. So, what we want to make is a bunch of these 16K guys right here, and there's going to be some other stuff we need as well. I believe I've got some... I hate the T thing. That drives me crazy. Here we go. We're going to need 32 ME controllers. I'm going to need an energy acceptor, and we're going to need a tesseract. Do I have? I do have an empty one. Good, good, good. Then, for cables, we're going to need some glass cables, and we're going to need a couple dense cables as well. Now, dense cables are made using ME cables and wool, so let's make a handful of those. And then let's make those into dense cables. And there we go. That gives me 64 dense cables. And I'll take some of these regular ones as well. And that should be the majority of what I need. I am going to need a crafting terminal as well. Let's see here. This I should have. Can I make one of these guys? No, I'm missing these little cores. Let's quick make some of those. There we go. And we'll make a ME terminal and turn that into a crafting terminal. Although, it looks like I need to make a crafting bench first. There we go. Okay. So, that's good. That way we can access our network. Is there anything else I need right this very second? I don't think so. We're gonna need an import bus and a chest. Do I have an import bus? I do, good. Oh, and acceleration cards. I am going to need some of those as well. Acceleration cards, here we go. So let's just make handful of those and make some of those as well, and then a chest. We want a big fancy diamond chest. A lot of you have been asking why I'm not using the crystal chest. The crystal chest and the diamond chest actually have the same amount of storage space, believe it or not. If you actually look at the number of slots that each one has, it is completely identical. There's actually no additional benefit for that, so that's just a thing to keep in mind. Okay, I think that's probably good for now. And we are going to head off to this direction? This direction, yes. And I'm happy to announce that I went ahead and made myself an Enderium jetpack, or a resident jetpack, which will help me move a lot faster than I could before when traveling these large distances like so. There we go. Kind of annoying to, like, it makes me jump when I don't want to, but for traveling long distances very quickly, it works pretty well. So, I hollowed out an area here in the base. This is going to be our ME room. And I'm strongly reconsidering this concrete-y feel in here. I kind of want the ME system to have more of like a futuristic theme to it. And I've laid out here where the controllers are going to go. So, essentially, an ME system has all sorts of crazy stuff, and I've been watching a lot of tutorials. Iskall, actually, on Hermitcraft, actually has a really good ME system, Applied Energistics 2 tutorial that I found. And then there's some other ones that I watched too. I watched like Direwolf's and a bunch of other stuff, and I tried to learn everything I could. And I will admit, I am kind of an applied energistics noob, but there were some really good ones. Non-Sanity is another one, another friend of mine who I used to play on a server with. He has a really good applied energistics tutorial about setting up your ME controllers and kind of maximizing your space. And he recommended laying out your ME controller like this. Each one of these sides of the ME controller has the ability to support 32 channels. So essentially 32 things. And this gives us a lot of size, and it falls within all the requirements of the ME controller, which is that none of the sides can be more than 7 blocks in length, and they can't be bordering more than 3 other controller blocks. So like this one, for example, is here, here, and here. But this will give us probably more channels to work with than we will ever use, honestly. This will be more than adequate, and then we've got our energy acceptor right here in the middle to kind of power this thing. And I'm going to put a tesseract right here, and energy receive, item, send receive, we'll say energy send receive. Yeah, there we go. And now this is all lit up all pretty and neon and fluorescent to show that it's working, which is good. Now, as far as our drives go, our ME storage drives, we need to figure out where we're going to put those, and I'm kind of thinking we'll put some of them right here, maybe? Or maybe over here. Actually, yeah, what's on the other side of this wall? Is this the sheep farm? Let's just take a peek. What's back here? Okay. Part of my problem with designing this, room, is that if you punch through this wall, you actually run into the reactor room right here. So, there's not really a whole lot we can do. I mean, I suppose we could change certain things. Maybe we could probably still make this work now that I'm actually kind of looking at this a little bit closer. Oh, and this is also a little bit of an issue, this one block right here, because I do want this pattern in the hallway to stay the same. But I think we could probably work around this a little bit and make this kind of cool, in fact. So I think we'll be fine. Anyway. So, ME storage drives. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to set up right here 8 drives like so. There we go. And then we're going to run a dense cable underneath like that. And like that. Okay? And then we'll take 2 glass conduits. and run them up like this. In fact, we don't need that or this or that guy. Those are unnecessary because this will work for this whole thing and this will work. Okay, awesome. So there is that part. And for now, I think I'm just going to put this concrete wall back. We'll go boop, boop, boop. Good. All right. Now, when these things get filled with drives, which we will get to momentarily, and each of these drives is going to be a 16K drive, so it's going to hold a lot of stuff, which is very good, we'll be in pretty good shape. We also need to put in some sort of way to access this thing. So for now, I'm going to put a terminal right here, I think. Ultimately, I'm thinking that most of the stuff is going to be underneath the floor. Most of the wiring and stuff down here, so it won't actually be visible. Maybe it will be. I don't know. I haven't really figured out how I'm going to fully design and decorate the room yet. Right now, I kind of just want to get the function up and going. So we have a tesseract here, which we will put. Actually, this needs to be somewhere. Let's put it here. Oh no, I still can't open it then. Where can I put that? Because this tesseract needs to be powering this thingy. I mean, ultimately, the chest doesn't have to open. But then again, we probably shouldn't put the chest in until we have drives and stuff like that in here. I think I'm getting ahead of myself. So, tell you what, let me get some more of the stuff that we're going to need put in. I know I want to have a wall of deep storage units for the stuff that we're going to have a massive quantity of, like cobblestone, smooth stone, stuff like that. And I want to get all the drives in here, and there's 160 of them, so that's going to take me a while just to transport them back and forth, and then some of the other things as well. So let me get some progress made on this room, and then I'll come right back to you. All right, guys, I am back, and I may have gotten a little carried away. The ME system is up and running. We've got all of our storage here and here. We have extra drives over here that are just empty at this point. I'll fill them up as needed, but right now they don't really need to be filled. This is plenty of storage. Each of these is filled with 16K drives, and as you can see, we haven't even fully filled up one of these things yet. I'm not sure why it went to this one first. I would have thought that it would have gone to these lower ones first and then kind of up the way, but whatever. Either way, so that's looking good. Over here, we've got, you know, the main ME controller, and then we can fall down here, and we've got all of our deep storage units, which are completely full. I've actually transferred everything over from the starter base area, which took a really long time, by the way, to transfer all that stuff, but we managed. We got it all done. We've got our wireless access point up and running, and I added some more wireless boosters to it. We've got a little import system that we've used before. So anything I drop into my ender pouch over here will go into the ME system. And then we've got our chest here for various import things like, the stuff that's coming out over in our ore processing area over here. Come on, keyboard. There we go. Our ore processing area or our sheep farm or any of that kind of stuff. So, and then as far as the decoration goes, it's a lot of laboratory blocks. I decided that I wanted this room to have really kind of a science fiction-y feel to it. But I didn't want to use a lot of really vibrant colors. I didn't want this room to be like seizure inducing. So I accomplished that by using a lot of laboratory blocks, a lot of white. And then the floor, there's a couple, like here, if you look at Wayla right now, it says carpenter's blocks. There's a couple carpenter's blocks in this floor that have glowstone applied to it to keep everything all nice and lit up. And then we have some glowstone in the ceiling as well. So everything is good there with the ME system, and we're basically set up and ready to go. Now, I do want to do a little bit of basic automation with this thing as well. which is something that I have never done before, so there might be a little bit of derpage going on here, but it'll be good. It'll be good. So there's a few things we're going to need, a couple terminals and things like that. We are going to need an interface terminal, and I'm going to need, actually, I'm missing stuff. Okay, let's just make, like, 20 of those, and let's make, like, 20 of these as well. That'll be fine. There we go. So we'll throw those in, and then we'll make some ME interfaces. Beautiful. And let's make, like, 10 for starters. Okay, so we're going to need an interface terminal. We're going to need a pattern terminal. And that might be it. I feel like I'm missing one, though. We've got the craft. Yeah, maybe that is it. Maybe those are the only ones I'm missing. Okay, anyway. So we'll do that. And then we'll grab some cables here. And we'll just go like so. There we go. So those will be here, and we've got a pattern area and then the interface terminal. The interface terminal will tell us all the stuff that's throughout our, basically our entire ME system once we get into patterns and all sorts of stuff like that. So we are going to need some blank patterns, which are made like this. Let's just make a... What? Oh. Haha. Yeah. Got it. Okay. Blank pattern. There we go. Can't type. There we go. Okay. So we've got ourselves 64 of those guys. That should be enough for now. We'll just put those in here. And then I think we're going to set up some of this stuff over in this room that isn't a room yet, but it will be. So let's just kind of dig out a bit of an area over here. And let's take this out as well. And I'm kind of thinking that this little area is going to go back to this concrete feel, is kind of what I'm thinking. I think we're going to go back to the general kind of darker, dingier factory feel for this. So let me hollow out a bit of an area here, guys, and I'll come back to you in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back. So I've got a little bit of a room kind of started here. And I think in order for me to kind of figure out how this is going to work, I need to start kind of putting down some blocks. So let's just kind of sneak some stuff in over here. There we go. And what I'm thinking is like right here. I think right here we're going to have like a little door frame like this, right? And it will bring you out over into this room. Now, this is where it gets a little weird. Because here, I need to do something as well. Because we want to cover up this back part right here. We don't want that to be the same. But I think if we do something like this, we can get away with it. Except there, you can still kind of see. We don't want this science fiction looking, you know, we don't want these laboratory blocks to be visible. So, what about this? Let's try maybe if we go concrete. I just grab a couple stacks of that. And we did something like this, where it's kind of at an angle. So we kind of bring that up. And then here, we would go back to this guy. Right? So we do something like that. And then up and... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like so. That should leave 5 in between, right? Yes, it does. Oh, that needs to go up a little higher, doesn't it? Just a little bit. Come on. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that. Okay, and then up here, we could do the concrete like that again? Or maybe up here we go back to this guy. Like so. That's not horrendous. I think that could work. And then we'll have, let's see, so this is 4. So we need to bring this out another 2. And that should give us the space we need, I think. Let's do away with that. That. And let's see. Those are both gravel. There we go. Okay. So this would be 5 there, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. That'll work out perfectly. And then we just need to connect that part there up. Okay. So I think that'll work for a room shape. I'm still not 100% sold on this, though. But I kind of think that if we were to go with this, it's just going to seem like too much of this material. Although, here's a thought. What if I were to use laboratory blocks there? How would that look? Just grab some of those and chisel those up. I think this is the one that I was primarily using. Just right here. We do something like that. Right? Bring this over. Maybe. That might be an option. Do I like that better? Yeah, maybe I do. I don't know. I'll have to think about that. Let me know what you guys think. Laboratory block here or this factory block here? If we do the factory block here, we can leave this for sure. I think it's honestly fine either way. But just something I was kind of mulling over, shall we say. So let me get this room all kind of decorated and looking good, and I'll come back to you in a sec. All right, guys, I am back. So we've got a room kind of laid out here and good to go. So the next thing I need to do is I need to start kind of getting some stuff in here. So first thing I want to do is I want to make myself an induction smelter, and I've only got a basic one. I'd really like to have more than that. Although, on second thought, maybe we go alloy smelters instead. Oh, I need to make a bunch of those guys. And let's see. Oh, I'm gonna need a bunch of iron bars too, aren't I? That's okay. Those are easy enough. Let's just make a couple stacks. There we go. And I don't know how many of these I'm gonna need. For now, let's just start with 5. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's make us. Okay. Since you don't want to let me do why do I only have 334 cobble in here? I should have a lot more cobble than that. Is something not hooked up right? Device missing channel. Did I? Really? Oh, these are all missing their channels. What is going on? There's only 8 things over here. Oh, this is at 0 channels? What? Hold on. What is going on? 16 of 32. Okay. And then it's 0 over here. What in the world? Let me see if I can figure out what in the world's happening here, guys. I'll be back with you in a sec. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I got it figured out. I'm not really sure what happened there, but I was able to fix it by putting a couple of cable anchors over back there, and now it seems to be working fine. That was still very strange, though. I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what the deal was. But regardless, it's fine. Sue, I was doing a thing, and now I forget what it was. Oh yes, alloy smelters. We were making alloy smelters. I remember. Okay, so let's make a bunch of furnaces. There we go. And let's go ahead and make 5 alloy smelters. And then we need some of these ME interfaces. And I think we will start our alloy smelters right around here. This seems like a good spot. Let's clear some space out down here, I think, because we're going to have to get down here with some cabling and stuff like that. So I'm just going to kind of knock that out just for just temporarily. And then we'll put down 5 of these, and on top of them put 5 alloy smelters. And then now the bottom of all these we're going to change to push-pull. So let me get that done. All right, so we've got that done. I've also put a tesseract in here, run some item conduits out the back of the alloy smelters into the tesseracts, and then run power from the tesseracts as well, so that way they have power, and they can go ahead and transfer stuff for me as well. So let's fill those in, and that should all be good. Now, what I want to do is I want to go ahead and set up a few things. We're also going to need a CPU. Maybe is it a crafting storage? Yeah, there we go. This is what I actually need. And I want a couple of these. So we're going to need a few crafting units. There we go. That was a little weird. All right, let's make like 10 of those. And we'll throw those in. And I think for now we'll go maybe like 4 of these. And then 2 of these for now, I think. Yeah, that should be good. Okay, now I need to get some dense cable. Here we go. And we got to run that down here and underneath all of these guys. So, and we want this to be separate from the rest, so let's bring that over here. And is that lined up? Yes, good. Okay, so we'll just kind of bring that to over here for now. That should be good. Except I've made one very, very important mistake. I need some of these guys. And we need those to be hooked in right here. And then this should all hook up just fine. There we go. Okay. So now this stuff should be online, right? Yes, good. You can see I can put stuff back into my ME system that way. Okay. Now over here, we're going to go 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, actually, let's go ahead and make 2 more of those like that. There we go. And we'll put one here and here, and then here and here. So these will be hooked up. That gives us several channels, gives us some crafting CPUs to work with. And then finally, I want to get some alloys basically ready to go. So I think we will start with Electrum, just because Electrum is a very common one. And then we'll do Invar as well, just for starters. So one silver, one gold makes two electrum. So we will take one silver, one gold. We'll change this to processing, and we'll say that makes two electrum. And encode, and there we go. We've got two of those. Then if we come over here, we can drop that guy in like so. And then I believe we can go craftable and we can make, say, 10 of these and hit start. And we only had two electrum in here. And you can see that's going up now. So there we go. And it is smelting right over here, as it should be. So, pretty cool. I'm going to want to put octadic capacitors into all of these alloy smelters, and I'm going to want to get a bunch more different alloys kind of ready to go on demand, shall we say. I've got a lot of Invar, holy cow. I probably don't even need to do Invar, but I'm going to anyway. So two iron, one ferrous. Let me get some of this stuff ready to go here. Whoa. Oh, I'm out of power. Okay. Well, am I out of fuel? No, just out of power. Okay. Well, power we can deal with. Let's just bump that up a bit. That should solve our power problem. I'm surprised that that's going through that much power. I mean, I guess it's okay. We've got power. We've got power to spare. But still, I have to say I'm a little surprised. We're up to 60,000 RF per tick, almost. Now, it's going to have to refresh a lot of that stuff. But there we go. Yeah, that should provide adequate power for us for the time being. So, I guess power is a thing. Anyway... So let me get some of this stuff done, and I will come back to you momentarily. All right, guys, I am back. So we've got a few different ones in here, and I think if we look at our interface terminal, yeah, it'll tell us. So we've got five different alloy smelters, and each one has these recipes. So we've got basically electrum, invar, energetic alloy, electrical steel, and vibrant alloy. We have all of those things. So if I come over here and hit craftable, and I say I want 10 of these, we should be able to hit start, and we should start getting inventory tweaks. We should start getting vibrant alloy, I think, right? That's working. It's doing its thing. Yes, it just takes a little while because vibrant alloy takes a while. But that's not bad. It's not bad. I think I'm going to have to sort a few things out. I'm pretty sure we've got some stuff in our ME system right now that we actually want to have stored over here in these deep storage units from when this stuff went down. But all in all, I think we're really good. And I think we are most definitely out of time for this episode, guys. So, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.